What was great, that was really more about Prince Philip this week, because there was so much more to him than just the embarrassing jokes. He was smuggled out of Greece in an orange when he was...
No, no, not at all!
It's not Chris Stengel!
Oh, my God! A little bit of raisin next to him. He's come so far since he was smuggled out in an orange!
No, we were talking about that gin!
And I'm the only person who read James and the Giant Peach and thought it was the Queen's autobiography.
He was smuggled out of Greece in an orange crate. That's what I meant.
Do you know what? That would be an exciting story until I thought about him being in an orange.
He was out of metal. He was smuggled out in an orange crate. Because his father was a... I mean, what's the point now? Blame for Greek military failures. And from this humble start, he then went on to build a career in the Navy. He was going to be commander of the Navy, and then he had to put it all aside, basically for his wife's career. Yeah. And his yes.
I mean, he had to give it all up for his wife's job.
Yeah.
I mean, he still gets to live in a palace. It's not. It's not
like he was going to. No, he's also going to have a normal job. You're not going to go, do you know who that scaffolder is? It's the Queen's husband, though. He lived in an orange. Careful peeling that, mate. Don't you check there's not Prince Philip in it. Do you know the worst thing to find in an orange? What? Half a Prince Philip. That's the worst thing.
That's why they shortened Philip to Pip.